Hi there. So I had a really interesting question come up this week, and it was about the ability to toggle between a relative date slicer and a date slicer with a range. And the reason the question came up is that we have a dashboard that contains a live tile that is pinned from a report that uses a relative filter that is filtering for the current month. So when that live tile gets updated a couple times a day, the tile contains information as the month progresses. The problem is that when users log in and access that report, they want to be able to select a specific date range in addition to being able to look at the relative slicer for the last month or the current month or the last 3 months. So it reminded me of a post that was done originally by Guy in the Cube, and I think it was Patrick that went through how to use a toggle button to change between two different types of charts. In my case, I wanted to toggle between a different type of slicer, but also preserve the way that the slicer was selecting its date range. So that's what I'm going to take through here now. I'm going to just pull in some sample data from our test server here, and I'm just using the AdventureWorks database. So there's a separate instance that we have here, so that's why I'm going to use the slash and the server name, and then we'll pull in the AdventureWorks database, and it's actually the data warehouse version, and we'll go ahead and connect to it here. I'm going to pull in a couple sample tables. So of course we'll use dim date to pull in some of the date information. We'll take dim product just to get some product info, and then fact internet sales contains the data of the actual sales. So we'll load that information in. When it loads, I have to go change the relationships that are inside the tables that it defaults to, specifically the ones for the date, because it's going to pick up multiple dates. So let's go over to the relationships here, and I'm going to take off ship date. I don't want that relationship. I also don't want due date right now for this example. We'll just leave order date. And so I'll double click that line and we'll make that relationship active, click OK, and then go back to our report. So this isn't really a report building exercise as far as charts go. I'm just trying to demo how the toggle button works. So we'll start out with a pretty simple chart here, and we'll take from the dim product table the English product name, and then from the fact table we're going to take the order quantity, and that'll be the value that we're going to use, just making sure it's summing, which it is. All right, we'll pull that over here in the middle, and then we'll click the ellipsis, three dots here, and sort it by order quantity. That looks good. And then we'll go and add data labels to the end of these and see where we're at. All right, that looks decent. I'm going to add one other element to this particular report here, and we'll add a card that just has the order quantity as a sum in here. And so without any filters, I've got 60,000 pieces of data in here. Okay, now I'm going to add in a date slicer. So let's add the date, let's add the slicer, and now I have to add the date. So we'll take the order date and we'll drop it in there. And in the data warehouse version here, I've got data from 2010 to the very beginning of 2014. And I'm just pulling in a date range slicer. I'm going to hit the drop down here and change this to a relative slicer. Okay, and because I'm dealing with old data, I'm going to say I want to look at the last 4 years. And you'll see the quantity there changes. I'm looking at, December of 2013 to December of 2017. All right, so I've got a relative slicer, I've got the chart built. And you can see in here, I can toggle between the multiple different types of slices that I have for dates. I'm going to save this, and then I'm going to publish it out and show you what it looks like out on the Power BI service and show you where sort of the problem comes in. So I'm going to call this toggle button example, and we'll go ahead and publish this out to my Power BI service site here. I'm just going to put it on my workspace. We'll let it publish it, and then we'll go ahead and open it up, and I'll show you where sort of the issue comes in here with this particular slicer. So let's go up, pull it up. All right, it looks just like I had before. You'll notice though that that drop down button is gone. I have the ability to clear out this selection, but I really can't change the way this looks unless I edit the report, which I don't want my end users doing. So going back to Power BI Desktop, I'm going to have to introduce a toggle button here to get it to work. So let's go ahead and drag this down a little bit. And I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. And I'm going to go over and insert some images in here. And I have some stock images of toggle buttons that I've downloaded off the internet here. So let's go ahead and get into my pictures and just some app icons. Free to use, whatever ones you can find that that would work for you. These are the two that I found. So I'll have a toggle button on that looks very similar to the way the iPhone toggles work. All right, so we'll leave it like that. Make it maybe just a touch smaller. That's fine. And then I'll have a second toggle button. That's the off button. So we'll go ahead and pull that in. And I'm going to mimic the size of this one. So if I look at it, it's 96 by 56. So we'll do the same thing over here, 96 by 56. That's good. Now, if I were to make these two things sit on top of each other like that, they would overlap. One would hide the other one. So they look about the same size. And then I just want to add a text box here. So I'm going to call this a relative date filter. I'll select it, make it bold. Get rid of the light text type there. Okay, that looks fine to me. And then we'll just pull it next to what's already there. Maybe pull this up just a little bit. Okay, looks good. These are a little bit big, but for the example, that's okay. So I've got my buttons in place. Now I need to handle the way that the date's filtering. So I'm going to have one date that is relative and another date type that is a date range. So I really want to copy this box. So I'm going to hit Control C and Control V, and I'm going to copy the way that this slicer works, but I'm going to hit the drop down here and change it to between. So it gives me this between range. All right. I'm going to leave those two the way that they are. Now I have to add the bookmarks and the selection feature. So before I do that, to make sure you have it enabled, go to the File menu, Options, and then Preview Features, and make sure Bookmarks is checked. If it's not, check it, click OK. You may have to restart the Power BI Desktop to get it to appear. Once it's there, we'll go to the View tab, turn Bookmarks pane on, and turn the Selection pane on. And then I'm going to hide fields and visualizations right now. Don't need those. And we'll start setting up the way the bookmarks work. So what I really want to do is when the toggle is on, meaning that the relative date filter is the one being shown, I want to hide the between filter and the other toggle. So what we'll do is we'll select this toggle, which is the off one, and the between date filter. And we're going to go over to the selection menu here. I'm going to expand this just a little bit. And you'll notice that there's these eyes, these eyeballs, these eye icons here. And I'm going to choose those to turn those things off. And then I'm going to click the Add Bookmarks button. So the way that it works is whatever the current state of your report is in is the state that it will be bookmarked in. That includes the date range that you have selected. So I have last 4 years currently filtered. That's what's going to be saved in the bookmark. If I don't want that, I need to change it now before I add the bookmark, or I'll have to redo it over again. So last 4 years is what's going to be filtered. I'm going to click Add, and then we're going to rename this bookmark as relative on, because that's the current state that it's in. Okay. I'll go back and click the Show All button in the selection frame here, and then we'll select this toggle button, the on toggle button, and the relative date filter. And then I'll go over to selection and I'll hide those two. And so remember, the current state of the way my filter is set right now is what will be saved in the bookmark. So it's going to give me the data for all time. If I wanted it to be set to just a year, I need to come over here and change it now to something like that. And then when I add the bookmark, it will preserve the way the filter is saved now. This is an important distinction to make when you're saving these bookmarks, because if you really wanted to look at just the current month for that filter, so you pin the live tile, then you need to save it like that as part of the bookmark. All right, so that bookmark's saved. I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna call this relative off, because all the relative stuff is on, the range is all the relative stuff is off and the range is on, and the slider is off. Okay, so those two bookmarks are set. Now I need to assign those bookmarks to the buttons. So we'll go back and we'll show everything again. And then I'm gonna expand the visuals frame here so that I can format the image. And what I wanna do is when somebody clicks, a user clicks the toggle button, when it's in the on state, I want it to actually trigger the off state because it's being switched off. So under the link options in format image, I need to turn link on. And then instead of it going back, like I'm drilling through, I'm choosing bookmark. And then I need to choose the bookmark that I want it to trigger. And I want it to trigger the relative off bookmark, because if they're clicking it when it's on, that means they're turning it off. All right, go to the toggle that's off, turn link on for a bookmark, and then say that I want relative to be on because it's off. So when they're clicking it, it's going to turn it on. All right, so let's go back over. I'm going to show all, but I'm going to click one of the buttons while holding the control button down, because if I just click it now, it's selecting it. So click it while holding the control button, and you'll see that it hides that option. If I click the on toggle disappears and the off one appears, and the range now comes up. If I control click the off toggle, it's now turned on, and the relative date range now appears. And you'll notice that it preserved the way that the settings were. So watch this. If I go back and I expand the date time for the full time, click it off, and then click it back on again, it has now gone back to the default that I set when I bookmarked it. Again, I can't emphasize enough how important that is, because you may want it to do that, you may not want it to do that. It just depends on what your settings are, but it will preserve the state of the filter when you bookmark it. Okay, so I like the layout of all of, I like the way that it works. Now I just need to make sure the layout is correct. So I want those two, I want the toggle buttons to be on top of each other. And I want the dates to line up with each other like that. So when I click between the two of them, that's what it's gonna eventually do with the dates and times. Okay, let's go ahead and publish this out, and you can see what it looks like once it's inside the Power BI service. So let's go ahead and go and save it and then publish it. Send it out to the workspace. And once it publishes, we'll go and take a look at the way the toggle works inside the Power BI service itself. Okay, so inside the Power BI service, you can see that the toggle buttons here, the relative date filter is active. That's what's showing up here. If I go ahead and I switch it between the other filter, you'll notice it hides the relative and pulls up the toggle. If I were to change this filter to a different time period, you'll see there it's not pulling up any data because there wasn't any data for that time. If I then change it back, you'll notice it defaulted to the way that I bookmarked it, which is exactly what I was saying. Make sure you have it set to what you want it to be. The same would be true if I went back and said, you know, I don't want to look at the last 4 years, I want to look at the last 6 years. You'll see the data changed. If I toggle it off and toggle it back on again, it defaults back to 4 years. Okay. So that gives you a quick rundown of the way that the toggle button can work with the filter using the selection pane and the bookmark pane together, and then tying the bookmark pane to an individual image and having it switch the way that the screen is filtered and which visuals are turned on and off. I hope that helped and makes sense to you. Drop some comments, drop a like. Let me know if there's anything else I can cover in the video or any other points that you are interested in with Power BI. Thanks.